tallest point east of the Mississippi.
So here we are, waking up on our last day out here. The convenient thing about this thing is I have almost nothing to pack. I just made a cup of tea. I can put the chair away. And then, like, you know, I have no tent. I could leave it like that, which I'm probably going to. Might move the pillow because it's in my way, but pretty convenient. It is 8:40. So yeah, I leave here by 9. I should get to the top of Mitchell by 10:30, pending no traffic, like Klingman's a few days ago. Good morning from the Smoky Mountains. I actually don't know if these are the Smokies anymore. Getting foggy up here. Look at that view. That song bitch up there. Woo, buddy. So I lied, that wasn't the summit. We still have 2 more miles to go before I could even see it, probably. Wait. No, I don't think those are it. Maybe that one in the back. Oh boy. It is weird up here. We've got to be at least 6,000 feet right now. Hopefully there's a good view. So we're in a parking lot at the summit. 6,600 feet in the air. Doesn't really feel like it, except for the crazy drive up here. Let's go check it out.
It's partially the height, partially the sinuses. I can't really breathe. Way above the clouds. I'm out of breath. In shape. That's a big butt. That's a little butt. Point east of the Mississippi. Super sunny up here, pretty windy. That trip is now complete. With a satisfying finish at Mount Mitchell. Very red, pretty green. Not that big.
All right. One more sticker. This whole bag is full. Probably a dozen at this point. For the fridge back home. Got a cappuccino and a club sandwich
from a little restaurant, whatever you want to call it up there. Pretty cool place. Not a lot of people. I mean, it's really nice up here, but it was real foggy on the way up. And honestly, I think Klingman's Dome had better views. But this felt taller. It was a long way down. I feel like I'm losing my voice too. Anyways, now for the dreaded drive back home. I'm not looking forward to it. Step into Virginia. We're gonna watch some football tonight. It is 11:15. I don't get service, of course, so hopefully we don't get lost. All in all, this was a really, really fun trip. I'm super happy I did it. I was talking to my buddies the other day, and they were saying something like, oh, you're probably in a really great mindset now, and it's true. I'm super calm. This cold or whatever is the only thing annoying me. Just went with it most days. Had a couple plans, but all in all, it's just what I wanted to do when I wanted to do it. And saw some really great things on the way. All right, let's get out of here. Look at this map. This is how we get off the mountain today. Switchback city, bitch. Switchback city, bitch. Ooh, baby. The new river, same as the gorge from just a few days ago. That's pretty neat.
How neat is that?
So I'm listening to a podcast and they just had a great quote, and it was, every man has two lives. The second one begins when they realize they only have one. I thought that kind of applied. Good morning from the road. It's 10 a.m. here in sort of warm Lexington, Virginia. Just left, coming down the hill. Still not feeling great. But we watched the Bills win last night. Me and Bridge went into town and had a brick oven pizza and beer tap room thing, and then we took some pizza home to Kyle. Now we got a while to get home. Well, we're back in Buffalo. And I'm super tired. I don't know if I'm happy to be back here or not. Great trip. 6 nights, like 7 states, bunch of hikes, bunch of sights. Couple beers. What more could you ask for? I am going to partially unpack, but take the best shower and sit on the couch, do nothing. It's gonna be so great. I can't wait. Here's the aftermath. All that's dirty or pretty dirty. Half-eaten food. Wrappers, extra stuff. That cooler over there is mostly full, and I'm here doing this.
That's a ladybug.
That's weird.
I'm gonna go puck it with a stick.